Hello, and welcome back to our TechBytes series on today's Teradata. Glad you returned. This session will cover how Vantage is able to deploy across a broad spectrum of choices. I'm still Rob Armstrong, a little bit longer Teradata guy now, as your host. For all those other old folks in the audience, you'll know this line from the old Joni Mitchell song. While clouds are all the rage, it's important to understand that they have pros and cons. I used to like to say, every silver lining has a cloud. You need to understand those pros and cons because it's only wise to take a deeper look at when and why to use the cloud, and more importantly, the cloud databases. Well, it turns out we got it right a few years ago. Companies will embrace the cloud. In fact, they did embrace the cloud, but they embraced it with caution. Most established companies have their own data centers and have entire organizations built around the management and operations of those platforms. And all that infrastructure did not, and it will not, disappear overnight. Most companies are looking to leverage cloud technologies where it makes sense. And today that means companies will still need both a cloud and an on-premise offering in their portfolio. The trick is really understanding the when and the why. So yes, some companies will stay on premises due to security, regulatory, or data gravity type constraints. And others aren't going to just jump wholly into the cloud, but they're going to embrace a multitude of clouds. For example, a company may prefer a particular cloud provider, but then they may choose another provider for geographical regions or due to some availability situation. Or a company may prefer one provider, but may end up acquiring another company in a merger, and they've been using another cloud service provider. So they're going to have to manage and run on both. From a different perspective, companies may want to be on premises for their production systems, but they have a test and dev or a DR platform running in the cloud. All of these are considerations that must be thought of as you plan for the complete ecosystem. And we call that environment a hybrid cloud, where you may have different use cases being supported by different platforms in a coherent fashion. Well, the magic to making all that work is the software must deliver the same capability regardless of the deployment. If your test dev box is in the cloud, and it has limited concurrency or limited functions, or it's just managed differently than your more powerful on-premise production system, then you cannot expect to do adequate analytics development because you're working at the least common denominator. Well, fear not. Vantage is the same regardless of where it's running. You have all the tools and functionality on all the platforms from a software stance. Now, I'm going to be complete in saying that sometimes the platform is the limitation. Just because you can run Vantage on all the platforms does not mean all platforms are equal. What I mean is that if you're running at 10 nodes in one cloud, and then you bring up 10 nodes in another cloud, or 10 nodes on-premises, you will get different performance results. But you will be able to run all the same queries, and Vantage will be managed the same way. It's just important to understand that what you're getting is that compatibility. And this gets to the heart of the discussion. Vantage can be your bridge to and accelerate your success in the cloud. Don't take my word for it, because many people have tried to do this. They've tried to move off Teradata, go to the cloud with some other database, and unfortunately, the results were not as planned. So here I have a collage of several customers that look at moving to the cloud. And part of that moving to the cloud meant also moving to the cloud database. They were running older Teradata databases, running on on-premise, sometimes hardware that was 5-6 years old. And they took the promises that many competitors made that the migration would be quick. They could match or beat Teradata performance. Sure, they're running against old hardware and software. And in the end, it will all be cheaper. We've heard that story before. Then reality took hold. The migrations did not go smoothly because they didn't have the functions that Teradata has, that rich, deep analytic capability that we have. The workloads were more intensive than they can handle. And then with the brute force, or the auto scaling, cost skyrocketed. All these customers came back and took a second look at Teradata Vantage, this time using the latest software running on the cloud of their choice. By being able to run the same functions and queries, managed in the same ways, and have the flexibility of a hybrid architecture. They all came back to Teradata, and they all committed to Vantage in the cloud. And this is what I describe as going to the cloud and then being in the cloud. By being able to simply migrate from on-premises to the cloud without any code changes, you can quickly leverage these new platforms. Now, once there, Vantage can then start to utilize many of those first-party services available from your cloud provider. There's been a lot of work to simplify and streamline how Vantage connects to these services, and that will be a continued priority for Teradata as we move forward. That's just a short bit on how Teradata is deployable across your enterprise needs. If you want more depth on these topics, please contact your Teradata sales team, and they'll be happy to dive deeper with specifics that fit your situation. Join me next time when we discuss how Vantage delivers high value from your analytics. Until then, this is Rob Armstrong saying so long.